Hi, I'm April May, and today I'm going to show you how to paint this beautiful Cocker Spaniel. I guess she's not a puppy. I was going to call her a puppy. I call all dogs puppies, I guess. But she's so cute. I just love her face. So as you can see, I've already kind of sketched in my design, and I used a charcoal. No. I used a pastel pencil to draw this in. And over here we have my palette, and I'm going to start with, we're going to put some colors on here. Oops, are we not in focus? There we go. It may be having a hard time to focusing. Let me take this on. Check. So can you see now? Okay. Trying to get all my screens over here so I can kind of see what I'm doing. Okay. So I think we're going to use some burnt sienna. Some black. And some unbleached titanium white. And I need just titanium white. I think that's where we will start. For brushes, I'm going to be using a lot of rake brushes. And then possibly some round brushes. Let's see what else. I'm going to blender brush. And then I need some detailed brushes. Let's see what we got. I don't know if I want to get it's longer. Okay. And a detailed brush. Yeah. I'm just looking to see. We'll probably end up grabbing some more brushes out of here, but for right now I think this is gonna be good. I may grab a flat. Okay, so for the brushes, I will call those out as I go to use them, but I've got, let's see, about three different rakes, a blender brush, a round brush, a bright, and a detail, or a liner, like a liner brush. Okay. Set these over here. Check my phone real quick. All right. And I think I am going to start with the eye. Mm. And I think part of it, I don't have, looks like I don't have this part drawn in. So this comes up. I think this is actually the round part of the eye. Okay. Yeah, this is actually the iris part of the eye, and this is more the skin and stuff. Okay. So I know kind of where I'm at. I am going to need probably one more type of brush. Let's see. I've got a very small. Okay, to get this, oops. Why is that not wanting to stand? Oh. Okay, and then I also have, this is a 5-aught, like a detailed brush. It's very, very short. That may be about 1/4 inch long. It's not long at all. I'm gonna get some water. Forgot to fill up my water glass. Now I'm out of water in my jug. I don't actually have water here in my studio. We don't have water on this side of our property. So the first thing I'm going to do is just outline the iris, the colored part of this eye. I do need a paper towel. Okay. And we're just going to outline this part of the eye. And if you hang on just a second, I'll pull it up so I can see it. Make sure that it looks. I may need to get some glassine. Let me do that real fast. Because this is chalk, so I'm just going to end up smearing everything. This is glassine, and that'll prevent my hand from smearing. Sorry, that'll prevent my hand from smearing the chalk under there. So there's the white, then here's the line. There's kind of a line, kind of, I think it's on the inside of this eye. Palette has got a rock to it, which is essentially going to drive me insane. And I took some titanium white and kind of grayed my black out a little bit to do this section right here because it's not quite black. And if you need a little lighter right through here. And we're just kind of blocking in colors right now. This doesn't have to be perfect. Just trying to get color on there. And then we have kind of a tan color. Kind of a dirty tan. I'll get just a little bit. And that is... essentially this area right here. Okay, and this probably I'm going to round this out just a little bit. It's going to come from here, and I'm using just some titanium white with a tad bit of brown added to it. And actually, because I used a brown pastel, it's kind of blending with this paint a little bit. I And I know that for me, one of the things that can be tough is that when you are looking at your printed piece, like some people will print their picture out and some people will use their monitor for their reference photo. Me, I do both. I did not print this picture out. I didn't actually know I was going to paint this, so I did not print the reference photo. I have it on my monitor. And of course my monitor doesn't blow the picture up this big. So because I'm looking at a picture that honestly is about like this big on the monitor, you're sometimes when you go to paint something that's this big to this big, your perspective can be off a little bit. And so you have to just take your time and make sure that you're judging all of your areas. You go in and you draw out kind of your major lines for reference points, but you still want to make sure that when you go in and start adding in the detail, that you're judging where things start. You know, and you can do that by, like, for instance, this off-white part. When I drew it in, I didn't draw this whole piece in. I just drew, there's a really white piece down here. And then I knew that there was when I drew it in, I only drew this part of it as being the off-white part. But it actually, when I look at it, wraps all the way up to here, which is about the middle of this highlight, which this is going to be the highlight right here. So you have to make sure that you're picking up all that very subtle detail, which sometimes can be a bit of a challenge. And like I said, I struggle when taking a picture from this size to this size. I don't know why this is rocking so bad. I need to put something under there to stop that because it's going to drive me nuts. I also need to make sure that my lines are thick enough because actually in reality they should be fairly thick. Thicker on this eye. Part of my, I may have something over here. Let me see. To stop this thing from walking. Nope, that is quite a gap right there. Right, that's better. Okay. And this is the lid, which actually is thinner than what I've got penciled in here. Because that's going to, well, let's see, there's a dark line here. And you can, you don't have to use this size of a detail brush. It'd be easier if you used a bigger one. Okay. So it's kind of a light black, like a dark gray right here. So we are going to fill this. Yeah, we're definitely going to need a bigger paintbrush for right here. Let me now, where's my flat? There it is. This will allow me to fill in some bigger sections of this. It's going to go all the way to this corner and come down. There is going to be some black that kind of comes down like this. Okay. And there's going to be a highlight in here. We will do that in a minute or later. Now I'm going to I'm going to use my blender brush. It's the number 6 blender brush that I'm going to grab here, this one. Get some water on it, dab the water off. Then I'm going to get black and kind of fill the black in around here. And get some brown and I'm kind of building this brown up and blending it kind of at the same time. So keep just bringing it around. Okay, so we're gonna, there's a highlight up here across the top of the eye, so I'm gonna blend that in. Okay, and I'm gonna leave all this because I don't have blue on my palette, so I'm not gonna do the blue right now. So I'm gonna probably do, I think I need like a burnt umber, a little bit of burnt umber. I think I'll just get a little bit. And I'm going to scrub in some burnt umber because I want a darker color underneath this. So that my lighter color will show up. And I'm doing, this is very watered down. And then there's, so I just want this kind of tinted the right color. Now you do have to be careful using this thin a coat of acrylic because it can relift and I'm going to do this part also. If you're not using expensive paints, if you're using a more economical paint, sometimes this, a coat that's this, that's this thin can lift. So you just have to be kind of careful. And I'm only tinting this so that the color, the lighter color, shows up on top. So I need a light color, or I need a dark color down so that my light color will show up better. Tint this whole section. I may even get a bigger blender brush. We'll see here in a second. I'm gonna grab one. So this is a number 12 blender brush. That's just gonna let me get some more of this paint. And like I said, I'm just using this to kind of tint this canvas. I'm gonna have a lot more paint on top of this. And it doesn't have to be perfect. If you have too much water on your canvas, you can blot it off. See, when you blot it, it all just comes right off. So there we go. Oh my God, what is that? The fuck was that? Oh, I don't like things that fly. I think there's a wasp in here or something. Oh, we may have to deal with that here in a second because I don't know if I can handle that being in here. Now I'm all skeeved out. And now there's a gnat in here. What is going on with these bugs? We're still just kind of following her hair down to about right here. We're just going to fill in all this area. And really, we could probably lengthen these brush strokes out just a little bit. A little bit of water. I'm going to take a little of this unbleached titanium white and white. I'm going to lighten that up. And I'm going to come up in here. Let's see, right around in here. I'm going to add some white. It may still be a little too wet. Now I'm not using straight white, I'm just adding a little white to the titanium white, a little of the titanium white to the unbleached titanium white, right? Isn't that what that's called? All of a sudden unbleached titanium white. Okay, now we're back to the straight unbleached titanium. This is still kind of wet in here. I am going to pull that white down just a little bit. But I'm going to wait for that to all dry. gonna switch over to a different brush. Just want one that's just a little bit bigger than this nail. I'm gonna go with, this is a 1/4 inch rake. Sometimes, I think these were actually called comb brushes, I think is what they're called. When I ordered them, I got them off of Amazon. It says Royal Aqualon Wisp. And until you get them broken, they're real distinct. I don't know if you can see that. Let's see if I can get that. I'm gonna do it over the eye. Maybe you can see it. It's got a real distinct cut pattern in it. But as this one's brand new, so it hasn't been used. But as you get them broke in, the comb pattern kind of breaks apart and distorts. So it works. It actually works better as it gets broken in. I'm adding just a little bit of this brown to this titanium white and brown. Oops, that's going to be way too much. Just for another variety of color to kind of come in here next to this. See, and it kind of dirties up a little bit, so we're gonna use the brown that's too dark, so we'll work that, and we'll start kind of darkening this little area up. See, there went that thing again, I can hear it. Trying to pretend like I don't know that it's in here, but I do know that it's in here. Kind of hard to lie to yourself when you know for facts that it's in here. I've seen it. I'm just trying to stay calm. My dog is in here, and when I get freaked out, she freaks out, so. And my studio's not big enough for us all to be worked up. Okay, now I'm going back into just the straight unbleached titanium white. If I need to, I can always pull this color back in here to kind of soften this transition up a little bit from this darker color to this lighter color. And then it's going to transition into a much darker color along here. It's going to be much darker in here. So. And drag this out into here. Because this is really just fur right in here. Whoops. This is just, this isn't a hard edge. This is just where it's going to transition to that much darker color underneath there. Okay, and it does kind of, the color does kind of lighten up a little bit right here. As we go over this line. And I feel like it's going to soften up here. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead. There was a line here for some reason. Let's see. I think that was just my paint line. Now that I think about it. Okay. So I'm just going to transition back to this lighter color. See, and this may be a little too dark, but I can, if it is, I'll just go over it with a lighter color and soften that up a little bit. As long as I keep my brush stroke short, it'll transition fairly well from one color to the next. I feel like this is a little too dark right in here, so I'm gonna lighten some of this up. Up like this. There we go. I think that's getting better. These are gonna, okay, so I'm gonna get a little bit more brown again, go back into this color. Because as we do come over here, it does get darker. Here is white. And that's just a very soft. So up here is going to be white. Or light. It's not white, but it's. And then there. All of this needs to pull down like this to follow this hair growth. It's going to come out of there and then pull down. There's that. This actually goes all the way over, right? This, then this comes all the way over. There's kind of a break in it right here. Just getting myself situated. Now I will need to darken this up too, because this is going to come out some. I need my smaller paintbrush. So I'm going to grab my smaller paintbrush and get that. This is that burnt umber. Get a little bit of water so this will flow better. Too much water, just dab it on a paper towel. Make sure you're dragging these out following the growth of that hair. I'll pull some of these out longer because there's some darker hairs that are longer here. Okay. As we come around, keep following that hair growth. Now I'm gonna add some unbleached titanium white and come off of here. Okay. And over here, I'm going to just begin pulling some of that darker out right there. I may even get a little bit of black and kind of hit that with the black to pull that out in there. Right through this section, it is pretty dark, so I am going to use some black. Brush into the black, or into the water, and back into the black to help with my flow. Okay. Okay. Like I need to pull this out a lot further. And you can pull this out a lot further too, now that I'm looking at it. Go in with my brown. Okay. Now I'm gonna get the clean my brush. Now I'm gonna go back into my straight titanium white. Now I'm gonna go and try to back in and see that this should all be lighter. But now you've got a dark color underneath there, so when you hit this, now you can see those hair strokes. Or hair strokes. It looks like the growth of the hair. I need. So now I'm going back over the black with the titanium white and pulling the white closer to the eye. That gives you that transition. This needs to come in just a little bit. And I'm gonna let that dry and set up for a minute. I feel like this is too round, so I think it needs to come out to a point, come down, and then down. So this, let's see, I get some. I think I'm gonna have this go out like that, then this is gonna go straight up, and then I feel like it needs to come from right to the corner. I feel like it needs to be right here. This needs to be come out further. Out just a little bit, make this a little bit more square. Okay. And I need to work on this back here because we are going to be pulling this down. And then I'm going to grab just a little bit of this. This is burnt sienna. And I'm just gonna come off the little bit of that burnt sienna right there. I have this color. This, okay. Maybe more of this color, let's see. Darker. I gotta make it dark enough to where it shows up. And then this actually follows This, ooh, that's too dark. Let's lighten that up a little. And we're gonna follow that over. Feather that. There it is. I see it. Ha, now what? Okay, hang on. Back over by the other wall now. Okay, it's back by the other wall again. What has happened here? See, I freak out and I got water all over my palette or on my canvas. Not like that. Okay, and then this should. This is going to end way up here. Okay. And then we have this color way up here. Okay, so we're just filling this in. And this is going to be very dark. Yeah, like that. And that's going to kind of be back behind this hair. So I'm going to put this in and then I'll bring that facial hair back over it. And this is very dark back along this side. Okay. Get this all entered in. Entered in, filled in. Something doing. Oh, I did spray it, so hopefully it'll just stay over there and do whatever it's gonna do. I hate to kill stuff, but I can't have it flying around in here. Freaking me out like that. I don't like to kill things, but I feel like it's now down to him or me. This is my studio. He's got a whole world to live in. I don't know why he needs to be in here. Is just some brown in here. I want to make sure it gets put in there. It's dark, but there's more of a red color here on the neck. I guess it may come way over here. Okay. And then the mouth comes back like this. This. Yeah, this isn't going to drop down quite so much. Like this is going to come up like this. I'm just using a mixture of titanium white, a little bit of black, and burnt umber. Very little black, though. Okay, so I've got the neck all done now. I need to darken a section under here, maybe a little bit darker. And then some of this may be darker too than what I've got down here. Okay, clean my brush out. I'll start with just some unbleached titanium white. Now we're just going to be pulling this over this dark edge. Remember, this does dry a little bit darker, so before we worry about how much lighter this looks, I'm not even going to worry about that right now, because really I think it does need to be lighter, but this could dry darker too, so acrylics do tend to dry a little bit darker. And I'm kind of pulling the fur at different directions, so it's not all just one solid pattern. Kind of going both ways. It's like my boyfriend's on the four-wheeler. I can hear him coming. We do have a beehive down here in this, the yard of my studio, so he may be checking bees. Take some of that white and come back up here. Now that this is dry, and I'm going to hit this and try to get that highlight in here where it's titanium white and unbleached titanium white. Okay, I'm gonna take some of that and I'm gonna pull it up here too. So cute. And come over here. Okay, so I guess I will do some of the blue on the, let's see if I can find some blue in here. I think an ultramarine blue, just very little on my palette. And I'm gonna get my little detail brush and some white and some blue. A lot of white, very little blue. Okay. I'm gonna go. I guess. I'm just taking the straight unbleached titanium white, and we're just gonna fill out the rest of this. The rest of her face. And I am going to switch to my bigger brush. And I don't know where my paper towels went. On the floor. So switch to that quarter inch brush. I just want to make sure that the transition at this right here, her cheek is subtle and not where you can't see. There's a sharp line here. I don't want that. Making sure that transitions smoother. And then make sure we feather this out some more. Okay. Now we're going to keep this hair, goes from the nose and it goes down like this. And the bridge of the nose down. Here, what does it do up here? It kind of goes from the nose up like this, and then over, and then here it's gonna come over to here. Yeah, this is looking good. Okay. keep moving this over. There's gonna be some brown and black along here, I guess. So I'm gonna pencil that in, or pencil it in, I'm gonna work that in. Now there is kind of a dark spot in here. I need to kind of work in, let's say there's a dark spot off the bridge of the side of the nose is actually going to come from up here. That's dark. Then right here is kind of dark. A little bit of a brownish red spot right in here. Okay. And then all of this is going to be more of this color. Mixing that burnt umber and that titanium, unbleached titanium, because this part is kind of a dirtier, where the whiskers and stuff are coming out. This is just a dirtier color. And then it's going to transition into like a dark gray.